So, hi guys. Long time no see, eh? Thing is that I'm just having mind blows after another. Because my problems, issues I had have really showed me the way, kind of, that I already thought I knew. And the solution, yeah, it is the solution, and but there's just one problem. Many, I would say most archers have difficulties using or finding the solution, because you need to do it in one kind of manner to achieve the solution and use it. And as I said, never kind of miss sideways more than your bad releases, and that's an inch, maximum two maybe. So, and that really is, I'm not bullshitting you guys, this is so important. Because now I've been at home with my shoulder, and I've been really studying guys like, you know, my first hero, and I gotta say, I kind of rediscovered Howard Hill. And when I'm seeing him shooting and seeing myself shooting the films, man, I'm a total apprentice of Howard Hill, period. It's just that I've been kind of holding my anchor a bit longer, but I mean, Howard knew what he's doing. Man, the man had like almost 200 consecutive, what is to say, after another field championships, first place, man. And I mean, that's unheard of. No one will ever do that, no matter what kind of crappy films they made with him, unfortunately. But you can't take away how good he actually was. He was amazing. And then you look at, like, I mean, Ishii, natives, all of them are using the solution, but nobody's putting the finger on it. Jan Schultz made a four-part film on YouTube, how to shoot like Howard Hill. And he never puts the thumb on the one thing that is so important. I've been testing, and I've been testing, and then I saw Howard Hill, man. I always thought that he looked a bit awkward when he shot, because he has a very, very face-on look when he shoots, man. He's like that. He's not, mostly like there, maybe the head. But very, very, very against the target with both eyes. And man, that's it. And to achieve that, the easiest way to achieve, well, the only way to achieve that is the short draw. Yep. You need to go down at least an inch in your draw length. And once again, we're at the old arguing thing, you know, how to shoot. And many guys shoot like, no, man, you need to decide, are you a sight shooter, an indoor target shooter, or are you an instinctive shooter? Thing is that if you shoot the same distance indoors, even if you're an instinctive archer, you can shoot like this. You will probably bloody damn good, to be honest. But the thing is that to shoot in the forest, and especially if you're gonna hunt instinctively, that's not work. It's never gonna work. You're gonna shoot left or right all the time. You're never gonna have that consistency sideways. And I know that guys don't have. And the problem is that many, I don't know why, they're brainwashed by this Olympic style, because that is all they show on TV, man, all the time. So of course you grow up as a child to see them shoot, and you want to shoot like them, you want to do the Olympic style. And then you see, man, there's some guy shooting instinctively. You continue with the Olympic style, and no, don't do that. The target sight shooting thing has nothing to do with instinctive. It's a whole nother style. I mean, that's, I mean, for me it's so obvious, so clear. Because those two don't match, man. Because you're shooting after, you're sighting after the arrow, gapping, whatever you're doing. you need to have it here, man. Because you're not yardage estimating with your eyes. You're doing that before you shoot, and you put the arrow wherever you put it, gapping or whatever you do. That is not instinctive shooting, period. Believe you me. If you're going to be a successful instinctive archer, and this is what the thing is, it is actually even easier than I've been saying, and I've been saying that everybody can learn to do it, and man, yes, because you just do like all the successful instinctive archers have done, use the solution for years, man. They all do the same thing, and it's so obvious. Because I've been now trying for a couple of weeks. I stand, it doesn't matter how I stand. It's like my lower body is not even connected with my upper body if I just use that little thing. Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if I shoot with a tab, I shot with glove for over a week. Doesn't matter. I can shoot with my fingers. It doesn't matter. You know what else doesn't matter? It doesn't seem to matter if I draw short or long. It doesn't matter. Well, of course it does a bit. But if you short draw or long draw just half an inch, maybe even an inch above or down under your original draw length, the power of the bow really doesn't increase that much. So that's not much happening, because if you do it, you're using the solution, the sideways is not going to be a problem, and you're going to miss, well, half an inch up or down. It's just so amazing. It is so absolutely mind-blowingly crazy good. And this is what Howard Hill, I mean, John Schultz, William Brothers, have you seen that, man? That's an insane brother. He shoots here. He does like that, man. And although he's here, he's not angry, but he's using the solution, man. He's over the arrow. So, as I've been saying it too, you can learn to shoot however, man. But to achieve that, I will say perfect accuracy, well, the best you can have, you need to do some uncertain things. And it's just so mind-blowingly easy. And that is just, you need to short draw. Yeah, wow, go, yeah. Cork up the champagne, guys. Now you're going like, yeah, Greg, you lost it, man. That little thing, yeah, it is absolutely all the thing you need to do. I mean, go and check the greatest archer of them all, Howard Hill. I mean, Byron Ferguson, everybody does it. They're using the solution. And to use the solution, you are going to need to... I'm not going to cock it. So this kind of Olympic style... Even though you're above the arrow with your eye, it doesn't help you. Because I've been saying, many been saying, and I actually thought that you're kind of guiding your arrow sideways by having it under your eye, using the solution, you're guiding it and correcting the sideways shooting. And well, you are, but you need two eyes to do that. You get me? So how do we do that? Well, because if this is like my 29-inch draw length, and tilting, yeah, you have to tilt. You absolutely have to tilt. But you don't have to tilt as much as I do. But it doesn't seem to matter if you tilt this much or that much. I mean, this doesn't matter, man. It just goes, the arrow still stays in the same place. If you just release correctly, it's not an issue, man. Just follow the bow movement with your body, and your arm's gonna follow, and release gonna be right. So, but it doesn't matter, man. But you don't have to. Like Howard Hill does, he doesn't tilt that much. But what he does, what is so incredibly important, and what makes the solution work, it is the thing he does. He faces the target. Because if I'm at 29 inch, like here, I go to 28. And I've been nagging you about this so many times, that you go from this posture to this posture. That's it. That is the solution. To the solution, to everything. You believe you me. So how are you going to achieve that? Well, the easiest way is to... Okay, Howard Hill stood like this sideways, but it doesn't matter because the guy, he just faced the target anyhow. So, and you can clearly see that he's doing this if you see him shooting from behind, because you're not seeing his arm like that, like an Olympic shooter. You actually see him short drawing. He's here. And that is what I've seen myself doing and trying to correct, and that's just wrong, man. I need to do that. Because the thing is that, if I'm at 29, if I shorten my draw length from this to this, it's not that much of an issue, guys. Because you're kind of shrinking your upper body, putting your shoulders together, and you're kind of shrinking an inch with your draw length, kind of naturally. So you can actually still anchor. But you see my elbow, it's not over here, it's here. And it just doesn't matter. And you see one more thing. He's not up here with his elbow, Howard here. He's down here. That is also the thing. If you just keep crouch up and keep it down, it's not a problem. Not up here with the elbow, low down. And if I go really low down, it doesn't matter where I release the arrow here. I don't even have to anchor in my corner of my mouth, man, because when I start using the solution of facing the target like this, in the periphery, I see the arrow go straight towards the target. So it naturally goes like, it's not that important with the release thing. And man, I'm snap shooting. I am Howard Hilding, like crazy. I mean, I shoot like, bang. I do that now, and I'm so goddamn good. Sorry about the choice of words there, but yeah, I mean, the guy was right in so many ways, and of course, because if you're spot on the target, why should you hesitate by anchoring for longer and just messing up your shooting? Because it's a bit like timing, like when you're fly fishing, you need to have that perfect timing to cast the other direction. This is kind of the same way. When you're at your target, bang, you let it go. And it doesn't matter if you let it go before that. And that is the awesome thing. Because man, you can snap shoot stumps, anything. You just pass them, man. But you need to be there. You need to be there. You need to be facing the target. And the only thing I've been kind of thinking about doing is that I've been testing and trying this. Is it short drawing? Is it stance? Is it open? What is it that I have to do? So I've been doing different things, and first I thought like, well, I need to short draw. Yeah, but if I do this and short draw, it doesn't help. I need to face the target, and by that I'm short drawing. So I'm kind of facing the target more, and I'm short drawing, and that's it. That is the proper form for instinctive shooting. So guys, go and look at Howard Hill, man. I mean, the guy knew what he's talking about. He's the best ever. No argument there. So, yeah, guys. It actually is, I don't know, it's such a simple solution. And it's so easy to shoot. And you know, there's so... Guys, I've been in competitions many years ago, and when they're starting kind of doubting themselves or shooting badly in the competition, they start short drawing. Yep. So they don't go up there and do that. No, they do this. They do that short draw. They're using the solution. And they're opening up against the target and they hit. It's so obvious, man. A child does the same thing. He wants to do this. Hey, man. I shot my camera and it's alive. So, yeah, and it's just so so mind-blowing, because I had a friend with me, never shot a bow before. I gave him like 10-15 minutes on the lawn, just shooting some leaves, man. And I mean, he's never shot before, and he's not a bodybuilder, so a 50-pound bow was a bit hefty for him. So I would say when we came to the forest, he shot a couple of arrows, and then he kind of didn't have the strength or the stamina to do it anymore. So the guy starts short drawing, and holy crap how he shot. I mean, that guy, he followed me in the forest and shot the stumps with me. I would say up to like 20, up to 25 mostly too, meters. He hit them every bloody time. And you know, I almost fell on my knees, man. What is this? Man, Howard Hill reincarnated. Wow, he was that good. Man, I didn't get it until just a few weeks ago. Because he was short drawn and he wasn't facing that way. He mostly faced like, and he did that very short draw, and mostly he went up here and he released like here. So man, this is your mission. Try that. Go up, face the target, short draw, and let go here, let go here, let go here, just let go wherever on the same path, but keep the arrow beneath you. Open up your stance against them. One easy thing is to open up your way too much, because when you're then going to draw up, you're automatically going where you can stand, because you can't stand like this, eh? So if you open up very much like this, and then you... It's coming. It's coming. You need to see the target all the time, all the way until the moment you release that arrow. Because, I mean, look at sight shooters. They look at that all the time until they release. We need to do the same thing. We need to see our target all the time with both eyes as much as we can. It's just not enough to see it sideways. You can't yardage estimate. So it's so important to do that. And man, because you're using the solution, you're seeing the arrow go straight towards your target. The distance doesn't matter, man. You're going to be right on sideways. It's just a matter of yardage estimation shooting into your brain you need to do, but it is that easy, guys. I'm not kidding you. This is it. And I've been nagging about this so many times in different films. Face your target, open up your stance. You open up here, you're never gonna hit your arm. And release doesn't matter, take down your elbow. This is it. This is it. Not this high elbow, straight line. This is. Then if you tilt that much or this much, it doesn't really matter, man. You can go all the way down here and it doesn't matter, man. Just too much here and I don't know. You still have both eyes. I don't know. But it seems to work. Whatever you do, however you stand, whatever you shoot with. I've been using the dog bone quiver on my bow just to see if it does anything. So it doesn't matter. It just doesn't matter. And now you're thinking, well, you're shooting your Acadian, the complete center shot bow. Yeah, but it doesn't matter. I've done it with Big Jim, the Centaur. And those bows were like a mind blow. Once again, man, it's like there was something happening. There was like a new bow, man. It was sick, man. So open up your stance, face the target a bit more, go up, down with your elbow, and you saw that my release problems is gone with the wind, man. So that style, the Howard Hill style, solves so many things. Even though it looks a bit awkward because he's short drawing. His elbow is here, not over here. But yeah, if you're gonna be an instinctive archer, you need to do that. So yeah, let's do it again, man. So, face the target a bit more. You see, my legs are where my shoulders are, man. So I'm actually facing that way. And I usually stand with my foot, left foot, really before my right foot. I'm kind of facing that way normally, but it's so easy to achieve the open stance if I stand like this. So I open up myself a bit too much from the beginning, because then when I draw up, shit, I think I wrecked my own arrow, man. But yeah, I Robin Hooded my knock from like 38 meters. I had to check the distance, because it's such a mind blow. So open up your stance. Think about your shoulders every time you do this, and you're getting into it. Because then when you're kind of getting into it, the only thing you need to think about is kind of short drawing. Because when you short draw, if I go up to like 29, if I just short draw, it comes naturally, the facing towards the target. So, and man, that's it. And it's okay, it's easy for me to stand here and say that, but I know it's bloody impossible for you to do that on the other side of camera. But well, you guys, you sign up for my course, you who are already signed up, you're gonna be learning that. I promise you're gonna be awesome, man. So that course at TAS is going to be instinctive archery. I'm going to take away any style or anything you have about sighting. And it's going to be such a mind blow. It's going to take 3 arrows to convince you. I promise you that. And you're going to be following me. So just indulge me in Winchester. And well, guys, you're going to be awesome. Believe Gray. See you out there in the forest, guys.